Chauncey Rob from the St. John Theater. We did a scene.
Hello.
She only had me for two.
Yes, it is.
Now we got it.
Hi, my name is Kathleen Godhunter. Don't know me. You are a horrible person.
Oh.
It's okay. She doesn't mean that. Don't be so harsh with a nice audience, Kathleen. I'm Joshua Moore, and if you don't know me, that's perfectly fine.
No, it's not. That's worse. This is amazing, beautiful, wonderful. He is also single.
Save the shameless advertisements for the end of the show.
My bad.
It's all her bad.
Okay. So to start it off, just by looking at me, Josh, you can immediately tell what we don't have in common. It's just, it's in our faces, it's in our nails.
It's in our clothes.
He's an only child.
And she's youngest of four.
Like, my views on only children is, like, when someone tells me they're an only child, I'm like, that's what messed you up. That's what's wrong with you. Like, that's why you have a constantly
DE. My views on people who have siblings is, that's why you have trust issues, and you never
it's not always that food.
It's always about
the food. Not always about the food, Josh.
Like the real Hunger Games.
There's actual food involved in our Hunger Games, though.
I mean, there's the Hunger Games for food, there is the, you know, trust issues, and not to mention the being left behind at events.
Oh, you want to bring up that emotional time of my life? Fine, I'll tell the story, Josh. I'll tell these people the story.
Please don't. Oh, so sorry.
Here's the story, people. So, in elementary school, I had a large park wall, full minivan, if you can imagine that. And one day after school, I can't find my mom, or any of my siblings, or actually anybody in my park. Because you know what? They had left me at school. Do you know how long it took them to realize I was not in that minivan, though? Do you, Josh? Do you know how long it took them?
I don't.
Yes, you do.
Halfway home.
Halfway home. They were halfway home before they realized I was not in that car. And by it was too late. I was already crying on my first grade teacher, Mrs. Presley, who was trying to convince me that my mom loved me. But I knew the truth. Jason, Mom, I love you and I love you.
Wow, deep emotional trauma there, some emotional injuries. Speaking of emotional injuries, I've never had any. More physical injuries sustained by, you know, people related to me.
My sister Colleen gave me a black eye once. We were watching TV together, and I was laughing too loud. How does someone laugh too loud for a
person? It's called a cackle.
Shut up, don't you know that. So we're watching TV, and I'm laughing too loud. So she throws something at me, and it hits me in the face, specifically my eye. And so I run into the bathroom crying, because you know what? Getting hit in the eye hurts. And like my brother, who's also home, calls our parents going, Colleen's crying in the bathroom. Colleen threw something at her and hit her. She says it hurts. We don't believe her. The next day, black eye. Guess what, Patrick? It did hurt.
Wow, so deep PTSD there.
You know what? I'm saying all the bad stuff from my childhood. What about you being an only child? Say something bad about that, Josh.
Constant attention, always blamed for everything that happens. Yeah, I mean, aside from that.
Actual bad things.
Well, this doesn't happen to all of the children, but in my case, I do have a bunk bed.
Is it used?
No.
The loneliness. Suffer from loneliness. I had a bunk bed. I shared a room with Aaron for 11 years. Worst mistake of my parents' life, but we did. We had a bunk bed, and I always believed the monsters would eat her instead of me, so I was fine. And I wasn't lonely, unlike Josh.
I have friends now.
Now. But speaking of loneliness, one thing me and Josh do have in common is...
We're both single.
Is couples.
Couples, seriously.
Specifically, PDA.
PDA.
It's gross.
Seriously. Stop it. You know those couples who are constantly, like, on each other all the time?
Tate.
No, you didn't.
Other Canadians.
Oh, no.
You're never alone. You always try to make it like you're alone, but you always end up in the middle of nowhere where everyone else can see.
Everyone is like here, and you're here, and it's like we're watching a show that we don't want to watch.
Don't want to see that. We see
it. Anybody can walk by a priest, a nun, a teacher,
your grandma.
Dead grandma could come back to life. That's when the first thing she sees, bam, she's dead again.
You killed grandma. How dare they?
Stop it. Stop the PDA. You're killing dead grandma.
And the PDA.
So to sum up this act that we should not have done.
More regrets will be had.
Is that PDA is gross.
Stop it.
And being a child of many is so much more fun than being an only child.
Whoa. It's all about being an only child.
No. Many children.
Only child.
Many siblings.
Only child.
Many children.
Only child.
Hey, Flipper likes siblings.
You say that to me.
There needs to be
here.
Back in time.
Thank you.
the song of fog. A boy filled with wanderlust, who really meant no harm. He changed his clothes and shined his boots and combed his dark hair down. And his mother cried as he walked out, "Don't take your guns to town, son. Leave your guns at home, Bill. Don't take your guns to town." He laughed and kissed his mom and said, "Yo, Billy Joe's a man. I can shoot as quick and straight as anybody can. But I wouldn't shoot without a cause. I'd got nobody down." But she cried again as he rode away. "Don't take your guns to town, son. Leave your guns at home, Bill. Don't take your guns to town." He sang songs on the road, his guns hung at his hips. He rode into a cattle town, a smile upon his lips. He stopped and walked into a bar and laid his money down. And his mother's words echoed again, "Don't take your guns to town, son. Leave your guns at home, Bill. Don't take your guns to town." I hear the train a-come, it's rolling around the bend, and I ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when. I'm stuck in Folsom Prison, and time keeps dragging on. But that train keeps rolling on down the San Antonio. When I was just a baby, my mama told me, son, always be a good boy, don't ever play with guns. But I saw a man in Reno just to watch him die. When I hear the whistle blowing, I hang my head and cry. Well, if they freed me from this prison, if that railroad train was mine, I bet I'd move it on a little farther down the line. Far from Folsom Prison, that's where I want to stay. And I'd let that lonesome whistle blow my blues away.